Hello and welcome back. This is Frost Terror, and we are playing MLB The Show today. We just beat the Dodgers. We're in September call-ups, so let's see, who can we call up? We have two extra spots on our roster, it looks like. So who do we want to call up? Who's on our 40-man that's not in? Kyle Nelson. Ryan Nelson? Did I trade him? I did trade him. Damn. Well, shit happens. Merrill maybe for bullpen? Bullpen relief? For the majors. And then let's see, who else would like to move up? Who's our best non-pitcher? Who is Alec Thomas, maybe? Tommy Troy, he's a 69, gross. I guess Alec Thomas, yeah. Give us another left-handed bat. Play the game. All schemes? Go City Connect, why not? Why not City Connect, you know? Open, overcast. Let's see. Let's get... What's that Alec bat leadoff? Fuck it, why not? Wisdom in. Contact 69. Yeah, let's let Jake bat lead off there. Let's do that. Castellanos is taking the day off. Shore is enough. Grichik's here still. I gotta get him up to AB soon. I think this is good. Good stuff. Oh, get my water over here. Oh, and my phone. Well, my wife's gonna text me or not.
And welcome into the ballpark. Happy to have you with us. We're ready for MLB The Show's game of the week. It's the Los Angeles Dodgers and the Arizona Diamondbacks. John Shambi on the play-by-play with you. Chris Singleton providing the color. Here we go, Chris. It's another edition of September baseball between division rivals. So we should be in for a good one.
No doubt about it, Boog. Both of these clubs have the same goal in mind, and it's simply this: reach the postseason. They know each other really well at this point of the year, so there are no big surprises. Just go out and compete like crazy, execute one play at a time, and focus on clean baseball. That's all you can do this time of the year, and it's the most important thing to do.
Coming up on the first pitch, and on the hill, the big righty, Paul Skenes. Chris, he's got the ability to take control of a game when he's out there.
Well, incredible mound presence, and he's going to attack hitters. Look at that strikeout for nine ratio over 10 coming into this start. So he's a pitcher that wants the ball. He's aggressive. He knows that he can get the swing and miss, especially when he needs it most. We'll see how effective he is in this one.
And at the plate for the Dodgers, Nolan Jones.
All right, let's see. Let's go, Skenes.
Well, he's really working that inside corner.
This is a different scorebook.
Hated that pitch. So tough to get the barrel to and to keep it fair.
Foul ball still, a 1-2 count. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout.
Just indecisive in that at bat. He couldn't commit to the slider. Trying to sit in between. Just not able to put the bat on the ball.
And now it's Gavin Lux. The shortstop takes the ball.
He got two balls, one strike.
Out to short. Tosses to first. Two quick outs at the top of the first here tonight. Two outs, bases empty. Shohei Ohtani steps to the plate for the Dodgers. Oh, now this one is blasted to right. Forget it. Way back there and gone.
Yeah.
A massive home run.
49. Good Lord.
Home run of the series. It's 1-0. That was blasted.
Absolutely. No doubt off the bat.
Fastball for a strike.
Don't fucking throw sliders in the middle of the plate, I guess.
And the slider that's
the fucking whatever here. The lesson learned.
Next pitch inside. Ugh, and that's annoying. Ball three. Will Smith waits on deck. And a pitch. Swing and a foul ball at the plate. They'll do it again.
Schemes ain't making it very far.
Two down, nobody on.
Got a lot of foul balls already.
No question about this one. It's out of here. They go back to back, and they boost their lead. It's 2-0. Chris, he's homered in back-to-back games now.
Yep, seeing the ball well, and he's got his timing locked in. He's looking pretty dangerous at the dish right now. Back-to-back homers, always a special feeling at the ballpark, especially if it's your team that does it and those guys get to slap hands at home plate. This is the kind of thing that can really fire up a ball club.
The batter now will be Will Smith. Swing and a high fly ball deep left field. That one back there, and it hits the fence. Safely into second. He's got a double.
Stringing them together. That's three hits in a row. Turned on that inside pitch nicely and ripped it down the line to pick up two bases. That can be a tough pitch to keep fair, but his timing
is
great.
This is
going to
be a tough game, cuz.
He makes the grab, and that'll do it. But two-round tripper.
Gonna be a tough one.
And today's starting pitcher, Big Tyler Glasnow. And Singy, we were talking earlier about how he's doing a great job navigating through tough spots.
I've just been so impressed with when it seems like there's more pressure, he's more calm and settles in. He's done an incredible job with runners in scoring position. Most guys, they get a little tight, they start to aim the baseball, but for some reason, he gets looser, the ball comes out of his hand with more life, and he's able to wiggle off the hook of, you know, tough situations and get his
makes the catch for the out. And there's one away. Time to take a look at the Diamondbacks lineup. One of the more high-powered lineups in the game right now. It's built to do damage, and they got some hitters that could punish the baseball, Chris.
It's so fun to watch these players take their at-bats. I mean, they're so disciplined. Don't give not just at-bats away, but really pitches away. Very aggressive, competitive in the zone. And when they connect, there's usually some loud noise to it. So we'll keep our ears open today.
Swing and a ball lined out towards center. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's two away. Next to hit for Arizona, Christian Walker. That's to
Muncy.
Throws across the diamond. And that ends the inning. And welcome back to the ballpark. Here comes Chris Taylor. And that's outside. Singy wasn't very sharp in the first. Got hit around a little bit. Just wasn't able to locate particularly well. A lot of stuff in the fat part of the plate.
Yeah, Boog, he wasn't fooling anyone. It's a tough place to be because it's not always obvious what adjustments need to be made. Sometimes it's location. Sometimes it's being too predictable. Sometimes you're tipping your pitches. He's going to need to figure it out quickly, though.
And strike two.
Yeah, hit that bitch. Take that, Pete Crow Armstrong.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Now two away.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way. But that time, a little anxious.
Miguel Rojas at the plate. That one's in there. That is strike two. Just missed.
Oh,
really good take, especially with two strikes.
Two outs, bases empty. Check swing on the 2-2. Appeal to first. Didn't go. Two outs. And that one inside, off the inside edge.
Come on. Swing the bat, motherfucker.
After a long at bat. So the lineup flips over. Nolan Jones now at the plate. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Rojas off of first with two away. Pulled the string on the changeup. So no runs, no base.
Yeah, he's only going to go like four or five innings.
Here's Pete Alonso. The 1-1. Foul ball there.
Always early on that shit. And he's got a slider and a curveball, so that down bottom corner. So.
Glass now, ready to deal.
Nope,
good eye right
was
there.
Not expecting a fastball.
Just missing off the plate there, according to the umpire. And out there on the mound, maybe trying to get an explanation. Can't say he's convinced, but it looks like he's accepted it.
Right-hander kicks, deals. And that one is lifted in the air. Jones, as this one sized up, makes the grab, one away. Here's Lourdes Gurriel.
You understand, like, I'm getting a lot of good stuff and just not, it's not working for me.
Liner, base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one out single.
Everything there we go. Much
him.
Better.
Put a great swing on that ball. Took the barrel right to it. Nice extension as well. 105 exit velocity. That tells you everything you need to know about that swing.
That one down the line, and that's just
oh, that's there. Come on, give me that one, man.
Next pitch misses way outside.
Got some cut action to it. Velocity pretty good on that slider. So far, moving the ball around nicely.
Run around the move. At the belt and fires. Runner goes again. Can't field it cleanly. Still able to get it there.
Oh, he got him at first? What?
Fast runner, but they get the out.
This is what it's all about on that right side of the diamond when you've got the first baseman involved and the pitcher as well. First baseman does a great job, knocks the ball down, gets away from a little bit, doesn't panic. The pitcher's exactly where he's supposed to be. Nice feed and a nice play for the out.
The 1-2. Popped up, foul territory behind the plate. And that's the inning. One left for the Diamondbacks. They trail it here, 2-0. New inning getting started. And now the shortstop, Gavin Lux.
Gavin Lux.
The pitch. Way out front for strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
High fly ball down the left field line. Thomas. Makes a nice grab at a full sprint. Here's Shohei Ohtani. When he first joined the league, the Angels batted him eighth, and he wouldn't hit on day.
Yep,
ouch,
got
that one.
Take
got him.
Well, the bad news is that pitch wasn't close. The good news, they're set up to turn two and get out of the inning.
Runner on at first with one gone. Down the third baseman, Max Muncy.
One ball.
Ohtani stands at first with one out. Got him. Outside pitch got the better of him that time.
We'll go tell you, when he goes to look at the video of that pitch, he's going to want to punch himself. That slider had hit me written all over it, and clearly he just got a little too excited.
Okay, thanks.
Tell you what, when you get a pitch like that, you cannot miss it. Those have a chance to go a long way.
He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. So the Dodgers leave one, but they're on top 2-0. As we go to the last of the third, Alec Thomas now. The other way. Crow Armstrong flashes the leather on the run and catch.
Man, we're trying to make your return to the D-backs a good one, man.
One down, base is empty. Way inside, gets out of the way.
I really need another catcher.
Field.
We need Adrian Del Castillo.
Hayward.
In that power.
For the second out. So back to the top of the Arizona lineup, Jake McCarthy stands in now for the Diamondbacks. Two down, nobody on. That one pushed foul out of play off to the left.
Yeah.
The 1-2. Foul ball left side. He'll see another.
Oh, he almost got there. Inside?
The pitch.
Yep.
And another ball. The D-backs down by a pair here in game three of this four-game
series.
To the right
a pair
side.
Is nothing.
Rojas tosses to the pitcher covering the bag.
Yeah, I think he was safe.
Start of the fourth and at the
a
plate.
A pair is nothing Jason as long as I'm not giving up like a couple more.
You know, these Dodgers showing great discipline at the plate, and patience definitely that seems to be the name of their game in this one. They're doing a good job of working the pitch count, and they've been able to push a couple of runs across to score as well.
On the ground right side. Steps on first for the out.
Well, he didn't recognize changeup earlier enough. Got out in front a little bit, rolled over on it, and beat it into the ground.
Chris Taylor getting ready to hit. Fastball for a strike.
Still relatively early, but with a pair of runs already on the board, the ripple effect of that high pitch count might set him up to do more damage later in this game.
Oh. Taylor out of the play. Two outs, base is empty. And next for LA, Pete.
Edemus, Prolimus, Armstrongimus.
That's outside. Okay. And that's ball two. And that drops in for a strike.
That's a beautiful pitch. Paul.
That one almost got him. Two down, nobody on. Top half of inning number four. Swings and misses, and the Dodgers are set down in order. Nothing doing for the Dodgers here, but they hold a 2-0 lead. Back here at Chase Field, ready to go, bottom four. Here's Ketel Marte.
So, here's an interesting note on Glasnow. He's been known to look at photos of people he doesn't like before his starts. It's a way for him to kind of get angry, and then he carries that anger out to the mound to help him pitch. Sounds like a good strategy to me, but I wonder who he's looking at.
Christian Walker stands in now for the Diamondbacks. To the right side, Taylor.
Weak contact against the whole time.
Two up, two down. Next is the designated hitter, Pete
Alonso.
Two outs. Drilled out towards left center field. That's well struck back there. And that one's gone.
Beat hands to be able to hit that velocity fastball on the inside part of the plate. In my experience, when you're looking out over the plate, allowing the ball to travel, it's pure reaction to hit a pitch in that location. That's a tremendous swing.
And it finds its way through for a hit. And that extends the inning. Here's Garrett Hampson. The pitch. Runner on the go. Swinging a foul over the screen and back out of play. Runner on the go again. Fights that one away. Still 1-2. Runner on the move again. Out to short. Lux. Tosses to first. That ends the frame. But not before they're able to draw closer with this blast. And we're back. We go to the top of the fifth. And at the plate for the Dodgers, Miguel Rojas. Just off the inside edge.
On the mound, he had a little trouble back in the first, but it's been a different story the rest of the way. Really settled into this outing nicely.
Swing and a fly ball in the air out towards right center field. Back to the top of the Dodgers order. And now here is Nolan Jones. Swing and a miss.
One ball.
1-2.
Ball to tracks.
Just missed.
Oh.
Just spit on it.
Base is empty, one away. And we're at the top of the fifth. Struck him out swinging. Pulled the string of the chain.
Got him.
Punching out for the third time right there. He just hasn't looked very comfortable at the plate. A little unsure of his timing right now. Not picking up the spin and location of these pitches. He'll have some adjustments to make.
Just off the outside edge. And it's 2-2. Swings and misses, struck him out.
Never respects him, but
work of them there. Home half of the fifth coming up. It's the Dodge. Swing and a miss, and that's strike two.
Oh, he loves Dismish the list.
He didn't look ready for the velocity. I think it'd be a mistake to throw him anything off speed right here.
Next pitch is outside. And the righty deals. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. Got him swinging for the K.
I went up and realized it was going to be down. I want to see what it looks like, where it said it was at.
Slider's more for that horizontal movement, but most of the good ones have both vertical depth and that horizontal movement, and that's what we saw right there. Good drop on the break and got him to swing over the top.
On the ground, and it goes just foul. Hammer, base hit. So a man aboard now with one away.
Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there. And now,
runner on the go. And that one fouled off. Runner goes again. High fly ball out of the left center field. Crow Armstrong should have it. And there's two down.
Lanesies. Come on, Glass
back
now.
To the top of the lineup. And now here's the speed threat. Outfielder.
Bruce one for me.
Over to first, and he saved. Two outs. Runner takes off. Here's a high fly ball out to center. Hayward right there to make the grab. And the inning is over. One left for Eric.
It's a good game.
The desert. Here's Shohei Ohtani. Kicks and fires. Swing and a high fly ball down the left field line, but hooking foul.
Well, you got to give him credit out there on the mound. This outing started off a little shaky, but he's found a way to settle in and turn this into a pretty good start. Kind of shows you a lot about his mental makeup as a pitcher.
And another ball.
Well, just about to hit that century mark, 100 pitches for this game. As a speedy potential base runner, when with two strikes, you just put the ball in play. You don't even have to get a hit at that point. You can help your team just by reaching on an error. But some way, you got to find a way to shorten up the swing and put the ball in play next time.
One down, base is empty.
Nice.
Two balls, two strikes.
Swing and a pop-off. In
if I can
ground.
Get out of this inning,
Wisdom puts it away.
Paul, then I can just sit down there.
Two outs, bases empty. And up to the plate is Will Smith. Popped up to the left into foul ground. Wisdom drifts towards it. And a foul ball. Two down, nobody on. And we're at the top half of the sixth. Got him looking. It's a three-up, three-down inning. And we're back to the ballpark. Ketel Marte up to the plate.
You get Minter up. Minter hasn't pitched a couple days.
And that's off the inside edge. And a count 2-1.
Outside, maybe?
Hard hit left side. Oh. Whips it across. They get the out on Marte. And now it's going to be Christian Walker. And the right-hander deals.
There we go. He's just like chopping it on the ground, man.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield.
Glasnow picks the first. Walker dives back in safely. And here it comes. Swing and a miss. Looked off balance that time. Double-barreled action in the bullpen. J.P. Fireisen looks to be getting ready for manager Dave Roberts. Here goes the runner. Got him swinging for the strikeout. Blocked by the catcher, and he steals second base without a throw. And it's Lourdes Gurriel Jr. And a count 1-2. Moved to second, and he's back in safely. He goes down looking.
I disagree.
Back here at Chase Field. And the batter now, Jason Hayes. The left-hander on now, A.J. Minter.
And he's been racking up strikeouts at a high rate this year. Typically at least one an inning, so he'll be tough to get to.
Fly ball down the line. And that drops foul.
Well, on paper, it's favorable to have a fairly quick inning here with two of the three hitters he's set to face batting from the left side, same side he throws from. Well, that high four-seam fastball has become such a great pitch for pitchers to finish hitters off. They're trying to stay back with two strikes, make sure that they can handle something off speed, and just with good spin rate, good rotation through the zone, elevated a little bit, get a lot of swings and misses, and that's a really nice job right there.
And another ball. Bases empty, one away. Here in the top half of inning number 7. Stays alive. Here comes a pitch. Struck him out looking.
Got him. I mean, this has been a great game. This is a great, like.
Pete Crow Armstrong, the next to hit.
Playoff caliber game.
And he's down on strikes. And it's a 1-2-3 inning. Dodgers go down quiet. On the mound now, J.P. Fireisen.
Should be a good first matchup for him here. He's been doing a great job against right-handed bats so far this season. They've had a lot of trouble squaring him up.
Next pitch is outside. Looking to get the tying run on base. Late that time, and it's strike 2.
Well, and those hitters count sometimes can be a little too aggressive, and a good pitcher will play off of that. He's got to get a better pitch to hit.
In the air, right side. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. One up, one down. Now up next for Arizona, Patrick Wisdom.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit, and then from there can really settle in.
The 2-1. And that one fouled off.
He's not anywhere near the strike zone.
Right side. Throws the first in time.
Well, there's a lot riding on that at bat right there. Nice job of the pitcher to bear down, make the pitch, get the ground ball.
We could keep going. We could get Ryan Thompson up, but we can keep going, Minter. Is that okay?
Left-hand hitter waits.
Guys, miss it or what? Weak contact, very early swing. Look off, very early swing.
Gets a piece there, we'll do it again. Holding on to a one-run lead near the bottom of the seventh. There as he gets a one.
That
change,
it looks like it's going to be high and it just like drops.
We go to the eighth, and here's the first baseman, Miguel Rojas.
Inside, ball two.
Just off the inside edge.
Well, they kept him pretty quiet in this series. Still doesn't have a knock. I know you want to get that first knock out of the way. Maybe more will come, but you got to give some credit to the pitching staff. They've had a great plan against him.
Rips that one center field and a base hit. So now back to the top of the order. So the batting order turns over. Now it's the Dodger leadoff hitter, Nolan Jones. And that clips the inside corner. Rojas gets his lead at first with nobody out. Swing and a miss, struck him out. And he's gone for the fourth time tonight. Now it's the shortstop, Gavin Lux. Late on that fastball.
This guy absolutely flies. The defense wants to turn two, but they've got to get a ball they can do it with. Make sure you get the first out before you try to rush and get two and end up with nothing.
To third. The tag out. Shohei Ohtani up to the dish. Two outs. Fought off foul. Bows it off, still one and two. And now the lefty cuts and misses. It's a strikeout. One left for LA. They lead it 2-1. Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Brusdar Graterol.
Now, these are the spots relievers really make a name for themselves, late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
Activity in the bullpen for the Dodgers. Evan Phillips, the closer, is getting loose. Kelly also throwing.
This and I won't sign it.
And now the count is
get on base and I won't sign another catcher for the postseason.
That ball is foul and the pressure is building. And the tying run is on base.
Well, a great back and forth in that at bat. He had to play off some really close pitches, and somehow, bro, he found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
Making a move at first, on a pinch run, Corbin Carroll.
If you're a base runner, you've got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt.
Runner on the go, pitching for a strike, safe in second, and he easily steals the bag. So the tying run at second. Fouls it back with two strikes. Here's the pitch. Runner goes again. Battling here as he fouls it away. Man, is he fast.
It's so fun to watch.
Man at second. Strike three. Got him swinging. One gone here.
Boogie just ran out of patience there. He took a couple of pitches to even that count off at two balls and two strikes, but that time chased outside the zone.
An outstanding hitter in Ketel Marte. And a count one and two. With the tying run at second, here the bottom half of the eighth inning. Smoked on the ground a second. Off balance throw in time.
They get the out on Marte. That's a huge defensive play in the late stages of the game. It might not be the most challenging we've seen today, but it needed to be made. That's helping your team.
Fuck.
Swing and a miss. Slider right there. And another ball. And he deals. Good job to fight that one off. Three. Swing and a miss, struck him out. Now into the game. Corbin.
All right, let's see. Let's put... Let's get Jake out for Gabby.
Carroll, he takes over.
Now Kevin
behind the play.
Can you fucking let me do? Thank you. Much better. I get the put. I don't know, maybe we'll see.
Ryan Thompson will take over here. He has a great slider with tons of movement. That's down and in.
You got two balls, one strike.
That one not close. And now 3-2. On the ground right side. And he takes it himself for the out.
Right out.
And up next for Los Angeles, Will Smith. Hard ground ball, base knock.
Hands are all slippery, man.
The batter, the center fielder.
Here's Jason Hayward. Left-hand batter waits. And a swing and a miss.
One ball, two strikes.
And a 1-2. Got him looking for the strikeout. Called strike three and a fastball up in the zone.
Well, definitely a borderline pitch right there, and he didn't look too convinced as he headed back to the dugout. You know, those are tough ones to let go as a hitter, but with the human umpire calling balls and strikes, it's always going to be on you to protect yourself with two strikes.
Here's the second baseman, Chris Taylor, and a pitch. Falling behind 2-1.
They talk about his slider a lot, but like I'm here for the sinker, man.
Swings and misses. It's a strikeout. Tosses to first. Taylor is out, and that's the third out. So no runs here on a base hit, no errors, and one left. On to the bottom of inning number 9. 4-5-6 coming up. It's the Dodgers 2 and the Diamondbacks 1. Welcome back, and here comes the closer, Evan Phillips.
Well, he's the guy they hope to turn to out of the pen to lock down wins, so this game has gone to plan, more or less. Let's see if he can wrap it up here.
Stepping in, the long ball threat, Pete Alonso. He went deep back in the fourth, a pretty important swing of the bat in this ballgame.
Yeah, Boogie, he didn't waste any time. He jumped all over that pitch and saw it the entire way. You talk about throwing it up, he didn't miss a stitch on the baseball. Now, Boogie, this is a real tough place for visiting teams to come in and close out ball games for a win.
In the air, right field. Makes the catch, one down. That's a big first out right there, and that changes things.
Yeah, you can kind of see how just the hope and optimism has shrunk a little bit, but they got a couple more outs to work with. They got to find a way to get a runner on and get one around the bases.
Dbacks making a move for a pinch hitter, Kyle Schwarber.
Well, they're going with the lefty bat here, Boog, trying to improve that matchup for a very important at bat in this game.
Payoff pitch. Got him swinging. It's a strikeout. And they're down to their last out. Now a chance for Gary Hampson.
to right, and that ought to do it. He'll squeeze it for the final out, and the Dodgers hold on to win a tight one as this one ends ball game.
Playing meaningful games in September is always exciting. A win today, first day of the month. This will just add.
All right. Well, thanks for watching, guys. We'll try to get back next time.